Hey everyone and welcome back to the channel. This week's video takes us to the southern edge of the Shropshire Hills. Being strategically placed and now a crumbled medieval ruin, Hopton Castle was besieged in a notorious battle of the English Civil War. Join us as we walk the castle and find out what happened on the bloody battlefields and how many of the surrendered troops were brutally killed. This castle is only small, but it has a fantastic yet somber story attached to it. The origins of Hopton are that of an earth and timber Martin and Bailey fortification that was raised around the late 12th century. It was then built by Walter de Hopton during the Barons' War of the 1260s, where the Bailey was fortified in stone and a rectangular two-story keep was built. What's really interesting while we walk up to the castle is the front door is completely unprotected, and on glancing you can see how thin the walls are around the windows. This would have offered very little protection against an attack. It's thought that the castle was built as a high status tower house on the site of an older Norman keep. It was designed to look like an older castle, as it would have made a bold statement about its wealthy owner, Walter de Hopton. The de Hoptons were tenants of the Earl of Arundel, who had recently at the time built a similar tower at nearby Clung Castle. It's more than likely that the de Hoptons mimicked their landlord's design. The small alcove, what was known as the lobby inside, just after the porch, leads you in a direction to the stairs to get up to the Lord's private quarters. This was a large spiral staircase that connected the two floors and gave access to a rooftop walkway. This was closed, unfortunately, so we walk straight on into the undercroft and what is left of the ruins today to walk around. It's likely that the ground floor would have been the office of the steward, who took charge of running the castle, whilst the first floor hall was of high status, where, typical of a castle layout, they would have entertained their guests. The private rooms were in a larger southwest turret, and a second smaller staircase led from the hall to a heated chamber that was placed above guard robes with a twin-seated toilet. This was a very comfortable first floor apartment, worthy of a wealthy family. On the roof, they had access to beautiful views. This was with the tall turrets on each corner. And back in the day, they would have been much taller than what we see. The Civil War divided up the communities between King and Parliament, and unfortunately for Hopton, it was right in the firing line. Being part of the only stronghold that was held for Parliament, they were surely to be attacked by the surrounding army of Royalist forces. After being forced inside the castle walls, 31 brave men fought and held out for 3 weeks against 500 Royalist soldiers that continuously attacked them. The Royalist forces wanted control of Brampton Castle, not far from Hopton, and they planned to take Hopton as a base, from where they could attack Brampton Bryan Castle as a parliamentarian stronghold. With news spreading of this, supporters of the owner, Robert Wallop, who in 1644 owned Hopton, had Colonel Samuel Moore, who was the garrison commander, and a small number of troops to take hold of the castle for the parliamentarians. The troops set a fire to a house nearby the castle, trying to bully Moore to surrender, but he refused. The Royalists retreated, leaving a few guards to keep watch. But during this lull of fighting, Major Phillips sent for more men to join the ranks, and when they returned a week later with proper summons for surrender, Moore continued to refuse, even though he only had 31 men with him. But time was upon them. Up to 500 men attacked and broke through the chimney. And in the burnt out remains of the house, they completely breached the castle's defences and suffered heavy losses. Another week passed and more troops turned up with heavy artillery. Moore was warned that if he did not surrender this time, before the first shot was fitted, he would expect no mercy or quarter. More hand-to-hand combat followed, with the Royalists losing up to 150 men, whereas Samuel Moore said that only one of his men died and four were wounded. Though through reading Moore's diary that he kept, the history is told of detailed accounts of what went on here during the siege. But a letter from Primus Davis, who was part of the garrison at nearby Brampton Castle, reads that the men inside the castle were driven inside the cellar that was unfinished, where there was stinking water and the house was on fire over them, and every man he saw completely massacred, implying simply that this is where the men were left, and possibly the remains of their bodies could still be here today. Although this ruin is very small and not much remains, this is a perfect example to be able to sit down back on the benches that the Trust have provided and imagine life back in the siege, or back when the families lived here. The castle is full of really interesting historical timeframes, and if you watched or watch Channel 4's Time Team, they had an episode here back in 2009 where they managed to dig, record and film a process of an excavation. They managed to record an amazing few different finds, including a cannonball, a Roman coin, parts of a musket gun, a human tooth, and even a James I coin in incredible condition. What I find amazing is that they only dug up a tiny fraction of the site, and can you just imagine how much more still lays under the ground for future archaeologists to find one day? The castle is free to visit, with a small but nice free car park right next to the entrance, with awesome information panels and leaflets to take you around the ruin. Incredibly, this place runs on donations to continue to preserve and repair the castle, so that we're all able to experience history on our doorsteps. We would recommend close by Clung Castle, or the very beautiful Ludlow Castle, with its gorgeous market town, if you're looking for things to do in the area. Or the incredibly interesting Stokesay Castle, or you could just simply wander along the hills of Church Stretton nearby. We hope you've enjoyed the video today and would love to encourage you to visit some of these locations that we head to. Please hit that like button, turn on the notification bell, and consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. We can't do this without your support though, so we want to give a big shout out to our patrons and to all of those watching the channel. Thank you. We'll see you in the next one. Till next time.